Hi, welcome to BIS Talks on Chemical Department. BIS carries out the standardization activities through its 15 division councils, one of which is the Chemical Division Council, CHDC. Chemical Division Council is chaired by Dr. Saurav Pal, Director, Indian Institute of Science, Education and Research, Kolkata.
CHDC is responsible for directing and providing policy framework and guidelines to the technical committees functioning under its ambit and is responsible for formulating Indian standards in the chemical field. It sets up the sectional committees, defines the scopes and appoints their chairpersons and members. It also advises the relevant sectional committees on the subject areas to be taken up for formulation of standards in their respective areas, keeping in view the national needs and priorities.
Chemical Department is one of the oldest technical department of BIS, which was established in 1954. For more information regarding the role played by Chemical Department, let us talk to Chemical Department Head, Mr. Ajay Kumar Lal.
The Chemical Department of BIS formulates standards in the field of chemicals, which ranges in a very wide range from basic inorganic chemicals to paints, to glass, to air quality, to water quality, to solid waste management, to environmental management. This activity is being carried out through our 25 sectional committees, 28 subcommittees, and 61 panels involving more than 1,000 members who are the experts in their relevant fields. Chemical Department has formulated more than 1,800 standards till date. In this film today, we are going to highlight the standardization work being carried out in a few important fields like inorganic chemicals, glass, air quality, safety, leather, environmental management, protection, and solid waste management, paints and varnishes.
Chemical industry is engaged in the development, optimization, and monitoring of fundamental chemical processes. These processes are used in industry for transforming raw material and precursors into useful commercial products for the society. Chemistry controls the taste and flavor of the food we eat, the scents we wear, the look and feel of our clothes, and how the world appears around us.
Bureau of Indian Standards has formulated over 200 Indian standards on inorganic chemicals. One such important standard is IS 798, orthophosphoric acid. In this standard, a rapid colorimetric method for phosphate estimation has been incorporated. For the analytical reagent grade, a new requirement of manganese has been prescribed. This standard covers the requirements of nitrates, molybdenum, mercury, and aluminium. Various instrumental test methods such as ion chromatography for the analysis of chlorides and sulfates and inductively coupled plasma, optical emission spectrometer ICP-OES, method for determination of lead, iron, calcium, magnesium, manganese, arsenic, molybdenum, aluminium and mercury have been incorporated. Orthophosphoric acid is used largely for cleaning sheet metal before painting. In order to retard corrosion and prevent formation of rust, another important standard is IS 4200-2020 sodium aluminate. This standard was recently revised in June 2020 to incorporate requirements of cadmium, total chromium, mercury, nickel and selenium. The major application of sodium aluminate is in connection with water treatment. This is based on its property of forming flocculent precipitates of aluminium hydroxide, which are capable of coagulating entraining and absorbing finely divided suspended solids and colored materials. Now, another important standard in the field of printing inks is IS 15495-2020, printing ink for food packaging code of practice. This standard prescribes guidelines for printing inks for use on food packages. This standard was recently revised in June 2020 by incorporating prohibition of toluene under solvents category, phthalates under plasticizers category, and titanium acetyl acetonate under various compounds category in Annex A of exclusion list on the basis of their hazards to health and environment. Provision also incorporated in the revised version to restrict limit of the sum of concentration levels of lead, cadmium, mercury and chromium 6-200 ppm for printing inks.
Footwear is important because feet are how we get around. If our feet are comfortable, protected and well supported, we can walk or run further, stand longer and do more of the things we need to do.
One of the important standard is IS 15298 part 2, that is for safety footwear, which incorporates protective features to protect the wearer from injuries that could arise through accidents. This standard specifies basic and additional requirement for safety footwear used for general purpose. It includes test for mechanical risk, slip resistance, thermal risk and ergonomic behavior. Special risks are covered by complementary job-related standards such as footwear for firefighters, electrical insulating footwear, protection against chainsaw injuries, protection against chemical and molten metal splash, protection of motorcycle riders. In the last revision, IS 15298 Part 2 was aligned with corresponding ISO 20345-2011. Another important standard of footwear is IS 15298 Part 3 on protective footwear. There are two classifications of the protective footwear. Class 1 is for the footwear made from leather and other materials, whereas class 2 is all rubber and or all polymer. The standard covers 5 designs of protective footwear. One of the most important tests covered in the standard is impact resistance of protective footwear. When safety footwear is tested at an impact energy of 100 plus minus 2 joule, the toe cap shall not develop any cracks.
The growth in demand for leather is driven by the fashion industry. Being one of the best materials, leather has been used in manufacturing shoes and accessories since Paleolithic times. It can be shaped and cut with ease for its light and strong, and most importantly, it breathes. Let us learn more from Ms. Preeti Prabha about standardization in the field of leather.
IS 579 is one of the important standard of BIS. This standard for vegetable tanned sole leather is classified into two types based on their water resistant property, type 1 and type 2. Vegetable tanned sole leather is tested for apparent density, water absorption, resistant to cracking. It is also tested for few chemical requirements like total ash, water soluble matter, solvent extractable substance, height substance, sulfated ash of water solubles and degree of tannage. I am also very glad to inform you that BIS holds the ISO Secretariat of Leather Technical Committee, that is ISO TC 120 and its subcommittees for more than 40 years. BIS has made important contributions in the formulation of ISO standards like guidelines for preservation of goat and sheep skin, guidelines for grading on the basis of mass of raw cattle hides and calf skin, guidelines for grading on the basis of defects of raw goat skin.
As you know, glass is a versatile material with innumerable applications ranging from architecture to laboratory ware, packaging to tableware, to interior to fiber optics and beyond. So let's hear it from Mr. Mohit that how BIS standards is ensuring the quality of safety glass.
BIS ensures the quality of the safety glass through our standard IS 2553 Part 1, which is Safety Glass Specifications for Architectural, Building and General Uses. As a matter of fact, recently BIS has revised this standard in order to keep up with the latest advancements in the technology. For toughened safety glass, flatness, resistance to human impact, fabrication in glass and edge working has been added as new requirements. Surface compression and mechanical strength, that is 4-point bending test, has been added as optional requirements. For laminated safety glass, edge displacement, bake test, resistance to human impact, defects in central area and working on glass after lamination has been added as new requirements. Humidity test has been added as an optional requirement. Another important standard, which is IS 14900 transparent float glass. Considering the development in manufacturing technology, this standard is recently revised to incorporate requirements for dimensional tolerances, squareness, acceptable imperfections like spot faults, linear faults, optical faults and visual light transmission has been added as new requirements. The tolerance for nominal thickness has been made more stringent. UV test to identify thin side of float glass has also been incorporated.
There is a great importance for safety and health at work, reminding us that prevention is the best cure for workplace incident. BIS has tried to provide a solution for safe and healthy future at work by formulating standards on code of practice for testing of safety equipments, code of safety for operational hazards and occupational health and safety management system. Let us understand how BIS plays an important role in developing standards on preventing occupational hazards. We have with us Ms. Preeti Prabha.
One of the important standards is industrial safety belt and harness, that is IS 3521. This standard covers safety belts and safety harnesses together with the accessories such as safety lines, lifelines, safety clamps, hooks for proper use in safety installations. It does not cover anchorages, but it is emphasized that secure anchorage point should be located before using any type of safety belt. Few important requirements of the standard are static load test, dynamic load test, strength test for hooks and other main load-bearing metal parts and flammability resistance test for webbing. One other standard formulated by BIS is IS 10245 Part 1 on breathing apparatus. Breathing apparatus enables a person to remain in irrespirable and poisonous atmosphere for a long or short period and still retain his full physical and mental capacity. This standard deals with closed-circuit breathing apparatus in which the exhaled air is rebreathed by the wearer after the carbon dioxide concentration has been effectively reduced and the oxygen concentration enriched. It is used either with full face piece or with mouthpiece and nose clip. Breathing apparatus is tested for strength and resistance in water test, leak tightness, mass for material used in construction, and is also tested for face piece, mouthpiece, and inhalation and exhalation valves.
Mixing pigments with different binders successfully converts them into a material for uses as diverse as house paints, protective coating for metals, plastics, writing inks, and automotive coatings. Let's hear from Mr. Pushpendra Kumar on how BIS prepares quality standards on paint products.
One of the important paint standard is IS 17218-2019, solar thermoreflective exterior coating for cooling of rooftop. This plays a critical role in curbing the electricity consumption. Main feature of such coating is to reflect substantial part of sun's infrared, having high heat reflectivity and poor thermal conductivity. In this standard, lead restriction up to a maximum permissible limit of 90 ppm and toxic heavy metal restriction as 0.1% maximum has been prescribed to avoid hazardous impact of lead and toxic heavy metal exposure and its consequent adverse impact on environment and human health. It also lays down the requirement of maximum drying time and minimum solar reflectance index, pull-up adhesion and pot lie of that coating. Another important standard is IS 16361-2015, thermoplastic polymer-based coating, A, undercoating, B, finishing. The most important criteria of this coating is that it is based on biodegradable, non-plastic, non-toxic polymer-based coating and gives better protecting coating in comparison to conventional paint. Some of the salient features of this thermoplastic polymer-based coating are: after application and drying, it forms elastic skin having high tensile strength, elongation at break, which take care of expansion and contraction of substrate. Coated film skin is fire retardant in addition to other properties and impermeable to air and moisture. Skin is not brittle, so no cracking takes place even after prolonged exposure to open atmosphere, as observed from resistance to salt spray test.
Now, let's talk about how BIS standards ensuring safety for aquatic life by restricting phosphorus-based compound from soaps and detergent products.
In the latest revision of IS 4955-2020, household laundry detergent powders, the total phosphate content is restricted to 2.5% by mass in pursuit of minimizing adverse effect of phosphorus on aquatic life. Also, zeolite and trisodium citrate are recommended as an alternative builder for detergent since these are more environment friendly than the phosphate. It also restricts the maximum content of active alkalinity, which reflects the skin irritation potential of detergent.
There is nothing more serious to life than the air we breathe. With 91% of the world's population in places where the air quality doesn't meet World Health Organization limits and millions of deaths every year, cleaning up our air is a major issue. So let's hear it from Ms. Shubhanjali Umrao that how BIS standard is ensuring the air quality.
Air quality standardization for measurement methods is very necessary. It not only helps to obtain comparable results, but also ensures a consistent assessment of air quality. IS 5182 Part 24 2019 is method for measurement of mass concentration of particulate matter PM2.5 in ambient air. This is done by segregation of non-PM2.5 particles from the air stream followed by filtration and gravimetric determination. The concentration of PM2.5 mass on the filter substrate in the range of approximately 2 microgram per meter cube to 220 microgram per meter cube. The measurement process is considered to be non-destructive and the PM2.5 sample obtained can be subjected to subsequent physical and chemical analysis. Another important standard is IS 5182 Part 23. Long-term low-level PM10 exposure may cause cancer and premature deaths. The standard IS 5182 Part 23 is the method for measurement of respirable particulate matter of size 10 micron in the ambient air. This measurement is done with the help of an appropriate cyclonic particle fractionating device. In this, air is drawn through a filter at a flow rate of 1000 liter per minute. The PM10 particle is determined by the difference in filter weight prior to and after sampling. The quantifiable PM10 that can be detected by this device is in the range of 3.5 microgram per meter cube to 1000 microgram per meter cube for a 24-hour sample duration at about average flow rate of 1000 liter per minute.
The quality of water serves important role not only in drinking water but also for major industries such as steel, chemical, paper and pulp and many more which uses water for their production. So let's hear it from Ms. Shubhanjali Umrao that how BIS standards are ensuring the quality of water being used for industrial purposes.
Processing in paper and pulp industry is greatly affected by the certain impurities present in the water. Turbidity and the color affect the brightness and color of the final paper. This standard guides paper and pulp manufacturer in judging the suitability of particular supply of water in that industry and in planning the type of treatment required for the available supplies of water. It prescribes the tolerance limit of various parameters such as color, turbidity, total dissolved solid, and corrosivity for the water used in paper and pulp industry. Another important standard we have is on polyaluminium chloride, which is IS 15573. Polyaluminium chloride is an effective coagulant used to remove microscopic suspended matter. It is also effective for removing algae. Indian standard IS 15573 prescribes the characteristic, requirement and the method of sampling and the test for polyaluminium chloride liquid and powder. The revised standard include requirement and method of test for selenium and total organic carbon. The limit of chlorine requirement in the medium basicity powder grade PAC is modified to 37.5% by mass. ICP method for determination of heavy metals are also incorporated.
As most of the waste that is generated around living being is of solid nature, it is a matter of serious concern. Such waste can lead to many diseases like jaundice, cholera, hepatitis, diarrhea. Thus, control and management of waste is the need of the hour. Let us know about the various standards on waste management from Ms. Srishti Dikshit.
Solid waste is the waste of solid or semi-solid nature, which may include domestic waste, sanitary waste, industrial institutional waste, etc. And solid waste management is the process of segregation, collection, utilization, or disposal of generated solid waste. Standardization in the field of solid waste management helps in minimizing waste generation, maximizing the economic value of waste, and adopting environmentally sound treatment and disposal methods for the waste. Recently, we have developed the guideline standard on solid waste management, segregation, collection, and utilization of at household community level, which is IS 16557, and I am glad to tell that it is widely used by municipal corporations and various organizations across the country. This standard provides guidelines on how to segregate, collect, and dispose or utilize different type of waste.
Paper is a versatile material with many uses, including printing, packaging, decorating, writing, filter paper, toilet tissue, currency, and security paper, and a number of industrial and construction processes. So let's hear it from Ms. Srishti Dikshit that how BIS standards are not only ensuring the quality of paper products, but also providing guidance to paper industry in manufacturing quality paper products without putting additional load on the environment.
BIS ensures quality of copier paper through our standard IS 14490-2018. During the recent revision of standard, cut sizes have been incorporated in size clause. The requirement of brightness and opacity have been upgraded. Further, the requirement of additional variety having GSM 70 and 90 have also been incorporated. Another important standard is IS 17317-2019, gradation of post-consumer recycled paper. This standard provides guidance to industry professionals, organizations, individuals in buying and selling of post-consumer waste as raw material intended for recycling by the paper and board industry. The standard prescribes standard grades of paper and board suitable for recycling by defining their composition and permissible limit for outthrows and prohibitives. Outthrow is defined as material which cannot be recycled for paper manufacturing and during processing may cause damage to machine or interruption to production or reduce the quality of finished product. Some examples of outthrow are metal, glass, plastic, etc. The term prohibitive material is defined as material by presence of which in excess amount in packaging of paper stock will make whole package unusable. Some examples of prohibitive are carbon paper, wax paraffin, etc.
The new and emerging focus areas under Chemical Division are personal hygiene and health safety, specialty chemical products and guidelines for water treatment, safety in storage and handling of hazardous chemicals, material data sheets, work permit systems, etc. Safety glass, specialty glass and glass equipments, limit of VOC, toxic and heavy metals in paint raw materials and paints, safety footwear for armed forces, sustainable manufacture of leather, and paper-based packaging for food items and safety standards. Some of the important standards under development include indoor air purifier, bullet-resistant glass, low thermal expansion glass, fire-resistant glass, school shoes for boys and girls, firemen safety boots, sustainable manufacture of leather, shock tube detonators, printing ink used for silk screen printing, wood pulp, full body protectors, and industry safety belts and harnesses.
The interests of the common consumers are at the heart of all the activities conducted by the BIS. The process of standardization therefore serves a way in which the consumers can live a comfortable, convenient and assured life. As such, it is essential for the authorities at BIS to ensure that the consumers become a part of the conversation about standardization. Let us know how a common man can contribute to the standardization process and get associated with BIS. Anyone can download the standards from the website of BIS free of cost. They are also free to make recommendations because BIS believes in collective collaboration with the citizens and not merely serving them.
The BIS e-governance portal, Manak Online, provides a comprehensive view of its activities, including on standardization. This portal serves BIS Technical Committee members and also other users of Indian standards. Filters to view the aspect-wise Indian standards classified based on test methods, product specifications, codes of practices, etc. is also available. The list of Indian standards relevant to various ministries and departments can also be accessed online. Details of published Indian standards and draft standards open for public commenting are also available. Proposals can also be submitted through the portal to make new Indian standards. Details about the technical committees, members and their affiliations through Manak Online are just one click away.
Imagine a world where everything is standardized and you are assured about the quality, so that when you sleep peacefully, and when you wake up with excitement, knowing that your children are safe. In a world where the citizen is increasingly becoming a consumer, the nation sleeps peacefully not only when the borders are safe. We sleep peacefully when our products and services are also safe and secure to use.